Picture this. You and your best friend have just found an unattended wheelie chair. What do? Sit in the chair and have your friend spin you faster and faster, of course. But what if you didn't have a friend, and what if you still wanted to go fast?
Well, lucky for you, you've got the best friend of all. Conservation of angular momentum.
What is conservation of angular momentum? Well, to answer that question, first we need to look at regular momentum, which can be thought of as how hard it is to stop an object that's moving. Think of a bike that's going at 20 miles per hour, and then of a bike that's going at 80 miles per hour. Which is harder to stop? The one going at 80 miles per hour, obviously, because it's moving a lot faster. So from that we can tell that an object's momentum is related to its velocity. Now think of a bike moving at 20 miles per hour and a truck moving at 20 miles per hour. The truck is now a lot harder to stop because it's a lot bigger. So we can see that the mass affects the momentum as well. People like to call the velocity v and the mass m, and then say that p, the momentum, is equal to the mass times the velocity. But in angular momentum, now that we're moving in a circle, how will our equation change? Well, our velocity is no longer the amount of time it takes to go from point A to point B in a straight line. Now we're going from point A to point B by sweeping across a curve. So our velocity is the amount of time it takes us to cross that angle. We can call that omega. Now for mass, things get a little trickier. We can't just look at the mass anymore. We have to take into account how far we are from the center. Let me show you why. If you're holding a 1 kilogram ball, that's pretty easy. But if you're holding that same ball from a 10-foot stick, it gets so much heavier. That's why we have to take into account the radius, which is the distance from an object to the axis it's rotating around. We do that by looking at something called moment of inertia, which is equal to the mass times the radius squared. So now that our equation looks so different, we can't call it P for momentum anymore. We have to call it L for angular momentum. So what's this whole conservation business? Conservation of angular momentum says that without any torque on a system, its angular momentum will stay the same. And don't get too hung up over torque. That's just what's twisting it around and causing it to rotate. So if we want to spin faster in the chair, we have to increase omega, our angular velocity. We can do this in two ways. Let's say we have a certain amount of angular momentum. That gets split across the mass, the radius squared, and the angular velocity of the system. By applying torque to the system, we can increase its angular velocity. That's what was going on when we had our friend pushing us around. And now that we don't have our friend torque helping us out, we have to increase the angular velocity while keeping the angular momentum of the whole system the same. Now we can't really do much about the mass of our system, but we can decrease the radius. In order to keep the total angular momentum the same, the angular velocity will increase to compensate. My favorite example of this is in figure skating. As I go into my scratch spin, you can see that this red line here represents the center of rotation. The green lines are the distance to my arms and legs, which is our radius. As I start to spin, I pull my arms in and decrease the radius, which increases my angular velocity, making me spin faster, faster, and faster. But you don't have to be a figure skater to try this out for yourself. Let's go back to our chair. Here we can see the red center of rotation and the green line, which is my arm and the radius. When I pull my arms in, I decrease the radius and experience a burst of speed that sends me around. Now the best part of all of this is you can take your newfound knowledge of conservation of angular momentum and share it with a bunch of people who, after hearing it, will no doubt want to be your new friend.